In this video, I'm going to talk about what is voltage divider, how it works, and use the knowledge to make a voltage sensor, and use it to measure solar panel voltage output. Welcome back to Milliohm with only one L YouTube channel. This circuit is actually very important on electronics. Okay, let's start with this circuit. First, we will try to calculate the current that flows through this circuit. To do this, we can use Ohm's law. Now we get the current is 0.006 A. If you are new to electronics and have a question, can I use this circuit to decrease the voltage and power up my device? So the answer is no. Because as you can see, the current will be very small and not usable for a power supply. You will need a buck converter instead. Usually, this voltage divider is used on signal conditioning that we will examine later in this video. Now, how to calculate the output voltage of the voltage divider? To do this, now we have this equation. So in this example, the Vout would be half of the input, or it is 6 volt. Before we start the experiment, maybe you have a question. Why 10k, not 1 ohm instead? Did it will have the same output? The answer is yes, it has the same output voltage. But if you choose too small resistance, it could make the current is over, and your resistor will get hot, or even gets fire. You can watch my another experiment video about exploded and burnt resistors. Let's have an experiment. First experiment would use 2 pieces of 10k resistor as we calculated earlier. I will give this circuit input from a variable power supply to prove that the output should be half of the input. I connect the power supply to the ends of the resistor circuit and put the voltmeter to the ground and output between 2 resistors. So the voltmeter will measure the divided voltage. So the power supply voltage is the input, and the voltage read by voltmeter is the voltage output, or the divided one. As you can see, the voltage on voltmeter is about half of voltage on power supply. It works as expected. The accuracy of the output is affected by resistor tolerance. I have a 5% tolerance resistor, so it could have a little inaccuracy. Let's change the resistor value. The second experiment would be 10k ohm and 1k ohm resistor, so the output should be about 0.09 Vin. The third example is 10k and 2k resistors, so the output about 0.166 Vin. And now I will give you a quiz. I have a solar panel with a maximum output voltage of 20 volt. I wanted a sensor that can be used by a microcontroller like Arduino. So what resistor value I should use? I'll give you 5 seconds to answer. Here's the answer. So as we know, most microcontrollers like Arduino are only able to read analog voltage between 0 to 5 volt. So we need to divide the 20 to 5 volt max. You can use any value. But since I only have 3 values of resistor, that is 10K, 2K and 1K, I will use that 3 resistors in a series. So the circuit will be like this. I will take the output between the first and second resistors. So the equation would be like this. And the output is about 0.231 Vin. And if the solar panel reaches maximum voltage output, it will give the Arduino around 4.62 volt. So it is readable by Arduino and won't damage the Arduino. So these are the 3 resistors. On this experiment, I will measure the voltage output directly by Arduino and print the values to an LCD. Here's the sketch. You can download this sketch link in the description below. This sketch is actually just read an analog voltage from pin A0. To find the original voltage or the voltage input, you need to multiply the voltage by 13 and divide it by 3. And then I print both values to an LCD. So I connect the pin A0 to the output of the circuit and the ground of Arduino to the ground of circuit. Now I'll try to adjust the voltage output of the power supply and compare the voltage displayed on the LCD. Now you can see the voltage output of the power supply is about the same as the voltage printed on the LCD. And if you think the voltage on the LCD is slightly inaccurate, you can do the calibration by multiplying the value with some number. Let me use a real solar panel. I placed the solar panel outside and hook it up to my circuit. And as you can see on the LCD, the voltage is read as expected. Since our experiment have ended, so I think this also means that this is the end of this video. Don't forget to share and subscribe because more videos are coming. Thank you.